Today, I'll be walking you through 9 critical MacBook settings that will make a huge difference in your daily workflow and productivity. And stick around until the end, and I'll show you how to download these tips for free. So let's jump in. The first thing I do when I'm setting up a new Mac is change the display settings. So go to Settings, then Displays, and toggle off True Tone to stop your screen from adjusting its color temperature based on the lighting around you. While we're here, let's also disable Automatically Adjust Brightness to keep your brightness consistent. Next, we want to click on Appearance in the sidebar. Have you ever noticed your app windows sometimes get a tint based on the color of your wallpaper? We can fix that. Uncheck Allow Wallpaper Tinting in Windows. Now your open windows won't be affected by the colors of your desktop wallpaper. I also change how scroll bars behave. Change Show Scroll Bars to Always and enable Jump to the Spot I Clicked. This is much more useful because you can see how long a page is and where you are at all times. Next, head to Battery in the sidebar. When your Mac is on battery power, it might dim the display to save energy, but if you want full brightness all the time, tap Options and uncheck Slightly Dim Display while on battery power. For our next tip, let's customize Finder to get rid of all the clutter. Open Finder, then go to Finder, Settings, and select the Sidebar tab, and uncheck all the things you don't use. I'm going to remove external drives, CDs, Bonjour computers, connected servers, and recent tags because I never use any of them. Then I add in folders I do use. For instance, I'm going to add Pictures and iCloud Drive. If you have folders on external drives or cloud storage that you use a lot, make it easier to access them. I like to add the project folders I'm currently working on. Just drag those folders into the Finder sidebar, and you'll be able to find them quickly. You can reorder them any way you like as well. Now go to the General tab. By default, Finder opens to Recents, which is not very useful for me. I like to switch this to Documents. Also, I disable external disks and CDs under Show These Items on the desktop. Let's move on to the Tags tab. Here, I disable everything because I don't use them in Finder. Just my personal preference. And lastly, let's go to the Advanced tab. I like to see file extensions like JPEGs or PDFs, so let's check Show All File Name Extensions. And when I'm searching for files, I find it's better to search only in the folder I'm currently working on rather than my entire Mac. Otherwise, the search results are way too cluttered. Now, exit out of Settings, and we can customize the Finder toolbar. I personally find List View to be the only useful view to move through files and folders. Also, there's times I get lost in the folder structure as I'm moving around. This is easily fixed. Click View, and enable both Show Path Bar and Show Status Bar. This shows you exactly where you are, and you can click in the path to move to any folder directly without having to click the back button a bunch of times. Next, right-click on the Finder toolbar and select Customize Toolbar. Drag the AirDrop icon to the toolbar. I'm going to add a space next to it, and then I'm going to move the Share button over as well. Here's a quick pro tip. Once you've added AirDrop to your toolbar, sharing files becomes super easy. Just select the files you want to share and press the AirDrop button. Let's also remove any buttons we don't need. I remove the Gallery and Tag buttons, for instance. This helps keep the toolbar looking clean and functional. Okay, it took a minute to do the Finder, but we're on to the next step, dock customization. First, if you have any apps sitting in your dock that you don't use regularly, go ahead and remove them. Just drag the apps out of the dock and release, and they'll disappear. Next, open Settings and choose Desktop and Dock in the sidebar. Let's change Minimize Windows to use the scale effect rather than Genie to speed things up. It makes the animations faster and less flashy. Then, enable Minimize Windows into Applications icon. Now your minimized windows will go into their respective app icons rather than crowding the dock on the right-hand side. I also disable Show Recent Applications in Dock. Are you seeing a trend here? I want my dock to be clean at all times. Now, to maximize screen real estate, I like to have the dock automatically hidden when I'm not using it. So toggle on Automatically Hide and Show the Dock. Finally, while we're here, scroll down and tap Hot Corners and disable all of them. I personally don't like them. I accidentally activate them all the time. They're just not for me. Now, let's touch on customizing the menu bar. Tap Control Center in Settings. First, I toggle on battery percentage, and then I add Bluetooth to the menu bar. Some people like to remove Spotlight Search and just use the keyboard shortcut to pull it up, but not me, I like it right where it is. And now we want to tap on trackpad in the sidebar. If the trackpad feels slow, you can speed it up here. Then move to the scroll and zoom tab and disable natural scrolling. Now when you scroll down or up with your fingers, the screen moves in the same direction. Next, let's customize Spotlight indexing so it's only searching for things you think are important. By default, Spotlight will show you too many results when you search. When you do a Spotlight search, you'll see websites, definitions, Siri knowledge, apps, news, docs. Basically, it will crawl everything, including JSON and HTML files. Not efficient at all. So let's customize it to show only the items that matter. Go to Settings, click Siri and Spotlight, and uncheck all the categories that aren't important to you. Tip number 7, let's lock down your lock screen for better security. I like to adjust the power settings. I set both the inactive settings for battery and power adapter to 10 minutes. I also change require password to immediately for better security. And lastly, you might want to adjust your screensaver timing. I set it to 5 minutes. Now, let's talk about widgets. Many people like to customize their desktops with widgets. Right-click on your desktop and choose Edit Widgets. I like to add the large weather and calendar widgets, and I also add a clock widget. You can also add widgets to the notification center if you prefer. Tap the clock in the top right, scroll to the bottom, and tap Edit Widgets. You can search from here. Lastly, here are a few more miscellaneous tweaks to round things out. By default, screenshots are saved to the desktop, but that makes a mess. To change that, press Command-Shift-5, and then tap Options, and then Other Location. Select where you want screenshots to be saved, and tap Choose. Personally, I like to save screenshots to a folder in my documents. And here's a cool productivity trick. Create a smart folder that shows files open in the last 7 days rather than all the recent files. Open Finder, click File, then New Smart Folder. Set the filter to Date Last Opened and choose Within the Last 7 Days. Save it for quick access to recently opened files. If your desktop gets cluttered easily, use Stacks to organize it. Right-click on the desktop and choose Use Stacks to automatically group similar items, and everything will automatically be by type. And that's it. Those are the MacBook settings that can make a huge difference in your daily experience. If you'd like to download these tips for free, just click the link in the video description below. Please make sure to like and subscribe. It makes a huge difference for the channel. And thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.